featuring Karen Wheeler, Keep On Moving. Coming up, we've got a brilliant Pick Your Own playlist. And I think we found our favourite Robbie Williams fan in Leeds. It's Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 9 o'clock. This is Tina Dehealy. The typical annual household energy bill in England, Scotland and Wales will hit £3,549 from October after the regulator Ofgem announced an 80% rise in the price cap. That is the maximum amount suppliers can charge per unit of electricity or gas. The consumer expert Martin Lewis says some families' bills will be even higher.
The 3549 is an average for somebody on direct debit. The cap on the price on prepayment meters and payment in receipt of usage is higher. There is nothing stopping somebody from paying £10,000 a year, which I suspect some homes with people and children with disabilities who need special electronic equipment will be using. We are in an absolutely horrendous situation, and it is going to get even worse.
Ofgem has acknowledged the demand for gas during the winter could mean that prices are significantly higher next year. The regulator's chief executive, Jonathan Brearley, says the next Prime Minister and their new cabinet must provide urgent help for people struggling to pay their bills. Emma Pinchbeck runs Energy UK, which represents the industry. She's also calling for further government intervention.
When you look at energy suppliers, most are making a negative margin, have been for the last several years. It's one of the reasons we've lost over 29 suppliers from the market. So when you look at this and the scale of this crisis, we're talking about something far bigger than the energy industry can meet, despite the extra help that they've been putting in place, despite, you know, charging the maximum they can for the cost of buying gas.
There are fears millions of households will fall into poverty. 80-year-old Sheila Coral from Lincolnshire says there's nothing else she can cut back on.
I'm doing everything I possibly can. And as a pensioner, we are very limited in what we can do anyway, and we're just going to discover that, honestly, a lot of people will find they feel better off dead, to be honest.
The Chancellor, Nadeem Zahawi, has insisted he's working flat out to develop options for further support so Rishi Sunak or Liz Truss can hit the ground running when one of them replaces Boris Johnson on the 5th of September. In other news, Royal Mail has warned that letters won't be delivered today and some parcels could be delayed as around 115,000 of its workers go on strike. The 24-hour walkout is in a row about pay. Further action is planned on Wednesday and on two dates next month. Police in Australia have made their largest ever seizure of the drug methamphetamine with a street value of nearly £1 billion. Officers in New South Wales found almost 2 tonnes of it concealed in slabs of marble after they searched a ship that arrived from the United Arab Emirates. In the past hour, the carmaker Audi has announced it will enter Formula One in 2026. It's expected the company will supply engines to the Sauber team, currently known as Alfa Romeo. Today's weather, showers for western parts of the UK and southern Scotland, mostly dry and fine for central and eastern areas and northwest Scotland. That's the BBC News at 9:03.
Thank you, Tina, and have a fabulous weekend.
You too, Gary.
Cheers.
On the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker and on 88 to 91 FM.
Oh, I was waiting for the Onion Radio, it never came. Okay, it doesn't matter. Good morning, how are you? Friday, 26th of August, time to pick your own playlist every day at 9. You take over with your favourite songs. This morning, Gordon McWhinney from North Lanarkshire is in charge. He's requested the songs for his gorgeous partner, Amanda, who he can't wait to marry next year. Now, we're trying to work out where these might fit in the wedding. At least one of them would make a brilliant first dance. Not sure whether Amanda will be walking down the aisle to any of them, though. Anyway, Gordon and Amanda, brilliant, brilliant songs. You're gonna love this.